Hi, thank you for listening. I'm not on camera today because it's for vanity reasons. I've actually got a spot just under my eye and it's very obvious, and I know nobody wants to see that crap. As soon as it's away, I'll come back and show my face again, right? But I want to make this video about the Women's Equality Party. On the 5th of May, they are holding an election for the Mayor of London, right? So just to show you here, I have the video stats. There's 4,682 views, 54 likes, 411 dislikes, right? And it says on the 5th of May, give half your votes to equality. I don't know how you're supposed to do that, but whatever. Women's equality are standing in the 2016 London mayoral election and for the Greater London Assembly. Read our manifesto at blah 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 wherever. Anyway, it's just the nerve of these people to call themselves the Equality Party. There's one of the comments that caught my eye was, I won't go through the comments, but just to give you an idea what the video's like, right? I highly recommend, I'll leave a link in the description, I highly recommend you go and read the comments and add your own. They're very interesting. Most people are totally against this, including women, apart from this crazy bint, Jeanette. Wow, see the misogyny in these remarks? Women's equality want girls and women, as well as men and boys, to be safe. Is that unacceptable? that's the level of intelligence the women's equality voter has. She just takes it as read that men and boys are safe, so they don't need any, you know, special attention when it comes to safety. Only women and girls do. Anyway, this is a party political broadcast, and the whole point of a party political broadcast is it's basically an advert for your party to say to the people, look, this is why you want to vote for us. Now, if you want to make a good party political broadcast, what you should do is go to the Labour Party or the Conservatives or the Liberal Democrats or whatever else, right? The people who have been in the game for a long time and know how to play it, right? Watch theirs and learn from them, right? You see, and what they tend to do is they'll say the same basic things like, we'll improve health, we'll improve the crime rates, the tax and all that stuff, everything will be improved, right? But what they absolutely do not ever do, because they're not stupid, right, is that they don't show anybody in a bad light. Because if they were to show, a Chinese man in a bad light, right, that might mean that Chinese people will think they're being negatively stereotyped and they won't vote for them. So, if say it was the Conservatives, if they were to put out a party political broadcast, they would say, and we'll lower crime, but they wouldn't then show you a black man breaking into a car, because they know that would make black people just not want to vote for them. So they would just say it, but they wouldn't show it, you know. But of course, the Women's Equality Party are brain dead. So let's see how they do a party political broadcast, and you'll see why it got so many dislikes. Here we go with a stripe. Oh, it's all nice and sweet, green, this bird singing. But she looks troubled. Now, what could be troubling that young girl? That young... Oh, what's the politically correct term? Fuck it. Half-caste. What's troubling this little half-caste girl here? I wonder what it could be. Is it about to rain, perhaps? Or maybe she... I don't know. Maybe her shoes are too tight. What could it be?
Right, Vida. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Imagine a world where all women and girls are safe.
Yes, that's what it is. She's got a white dad. And as we all know, especially the Women's Equality Party, white men are evil. They are the spawn of the devil, and they've never done anything good at all. And the reason I know that white men have never done anything good is because black people use their iPhones to tell me this on Facebook and Twitter. Wouldn't it be nice to have a world where women and girls were safe? Aren't you the equality party? What about boys and men? Wouldn't it be nice if we had a world where they were safe? You also notice the white man has a scar on his face. It's like stereotype Ville, you know. Because as we know, if you're a white man, you're obviously already evil. But see if you've got a scar on your face, that definitely automatically means that you're absolutely 100% evil and a bad person.
Where those who experience domestic violence and abuse can escape.
Does that include the men and boys who are experiencing abuse and domestic violence? No.
Bye.
Imagine a world where we ring fence investment and build homes and provide services for women and children currently trapped in dangerous situations they cannot afford to leave.
Yes, let's create shelters and homes for women and girls who are suffering abuse and cannot leave. Forget the men, I think they only have one domestic violence shelter in the entire country, and there's like 300 for women and girls. But forget that. They're about equality, so they want even more for women and girls. Even more. But you see, here's the thing, right? Yeah, this is how you blow the progressives' mind, you know. What about gay men who are in a relationship where they're suffering abuse? Where do they go? Mm-hmm. That's what I thought.
Then maybe I'd have somewhere else to go.
Yes, listen, sweetheart. You have got plenty of places to go. Because you're female. You are privileged in your country. You've got plenty of places you can go for free, away from abuse. If your brother was suffering abuse, however, he wouldn't find it so easy. If your dad was suffering abuse, which is impossible because he's a white man with a scar, then he wouldn't have anywhere to go either. Certainly not without a lot of travel. Did you see the contrast? When the white man picks up his half-caste daughter, she's terrified, he's got a mean look on his face, he's got a scar, and everything's moody and depressing and bad. But when the woman's putting her child in a car, everything's happy, cheery, woohoo, brilliant. In fact, I'm pretty certain I've seen a rainbow in the background there. That's how wonderful everything is when a woman does it. It's all happy and cheery.
The Women's Equality Party will offer businesses incentive to build on-site creches and help with childcare.
Right, so you're going to encourage businesses to build creches and on-site childcare. Where are you getting the money for this? Would that be the taxpayer that would be giving you that money? Who pays the most tax, sweetheart? Aye, that's what I thought.
A commitment to making flexible working the default so that London leads the way in balancing work and life.
Yeah, so remember that part. Flexible working so that London leads the way, blah, blah, blah. Flexible working. Right, let's see how that pans out by the end of the broadcast, shall we? For everyone, remember, right, because they're about equality. Everyone should get flexible hours, right?
So that women can really take charge of their own direction.
Oh, so only flexible working hours for women then. You know, I'm not really hearing much of a case for equality coming from the Equality Party. It's very strange. It's like having a party, the non-racist party, and the first rule is, let's ship those blacks back to fucking Africa. You know what I mean? It's like so fucking the opposite of what they claim to be. Equality, my arse!
And at the Women's Equality Party, we want to see young women finally getting the respect they deserve.
Just what respect do they deserve? This is, you know, For years I've heard this, right? For years I have heard this about women getting respect and you have to respect women, and there's even been like actual advertising campaigns saying, you know, teach boys to respect women and all that crap, you know? And it seems it's very obvious to me that it's only females, women, who have a problem with earning respect. If you say if you say to a man, no, you need to earn respect, okay? But we say to a woman, you need to earn respect. No, I want it handed to me. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, darlings, you have to earn your respect on an individual basis. You're not just going to get respected because you've got a vag, you nutter. Uh-oh, there's a guy. Oh, there's another guy. There's trouble ahead. Oh no, I'm not talking about him. He's not white. Silly me. Sorry, just forget I said that. He's obviously not bad or doesn't commit crime because he's black. And you know what it's like. Blacks, crime, that's like water and oil. They just never mix.
We also have a plan to help fund specialist sex and relationship classes in schools all across London to help young people build healthy relationships and understand consent.
Now, what they just said there was, as a father of a young son, an absolute nightmare, right? And should be for any women with sons as well. You see, they want to have consent classes in schools, and she specifically said young children. So we're talking primary schools here. Now, I send my son to school. I want him to learn English, maths, geography, history, some sciences, you know, things like that. You know, that's why he's there, you know, to learn things. I don't want him going to school. Yeah, so I. Oh, how was your day at school, son? Oh, it was all right. What did you learn? I learned that I was a rapist. That's not really what I want from my son, and I don't think many women in Britain or London want that for their sons either. They don't want their sons to be taught that they're a rapist by default and have to be taught not to be.
So that they and I know what harassment is.
So you need the Women's Equality Party to teach you what harassment is? My God, man. Ugh. But it looks like the young girl or young woman, whatever, was hassling the older woman. That's what it looked like. I'm still not sure about that. Who's harassing who here?
We need to start spreading the word that the Women's Equality Party want to design and implement a cutting-edge public awareness campaign.
Right, so we need to spread the word that the Women's Equality want to have a cutting-edge campaign. For what? What are they? See, this is the thing all the way throughout this, right? They just say stuff, but don't say how they're going to do it. Right, they're going to have a, you know, a public awareness campaign, and it's going to be cutting edge. Right, how is it going to be cutting edge? Are you going to put posters everywhere? Because that's not cutting edge. Fucking never explain how they're going to go about these things. They just say, look, man, trust us. We're women, we've got vagies, you know, white men are evil, and we will just get things done. We'll do what we say, but we won't tell you how we're going to do it. Oh, aye, and white men are evil.
The Women's Equality Party want to work with organisations to help put an end to harassment and intimidation in all public spaces in London.
So we can all relax and enjoy this city.
Yes, that was hilarious, wasn't it? Were you laughing at it? So, this is what I mean, they just say things. She just said there, the Women's Equality Party want to put an end to harassment and abuse and blah, blah, blah. How? How have you got, we've had a system in place for fucking centuries. How are you, what are you going to change? You just got to go in, right, we're now the leading party. Let's wave our magic wand. Oh, look, there's no more harassment in Britain and there's no more violence. Aren't we the best? God's sake, you just don't even think about saying how you're going to achieve this crap.
A vote for the Women's Equality Party is a commitment to reducing stereotyping in schools.
Do you know, it's funny, is it? So it's a commitment. Vote for them and you'll end stereotyping in schools, right? How exactly are the Women's Equality Party going to change the way people think? Because that's what a stereotype is. It's people think things. That's it. How the fuck are they going to do that? You know, the funny thing about stereotypes is, right, see when I seen her, that old woman there. See when I seen her, right, my first thought was, she's a doddery old bint. I bet she talks one amount, massive amount of shit. And wouldn't you know it, I was right to stereotype.
And offering girls, as well as boys, an equal chance.
Aye, as well as boys. Fucking boys. Get that horrible taste out of my mouth. Can't believe I said that. Yes, let's help girls. As well as boys.
We will work with schools to improve all young people's technical skills.
And how will you do this again? Oh, that's right. You never tell us how you're going to do anything.
So that when my granddaughter grows up, she knows she can be whatever she wants to be.
Well, she already can because she's got a vag. Not only are there no barriers in place for her to be what she wants to be, but she's also going to get a leg up, you know, like in the STEM field, she's twice as likely to get a job in that than men are, because all the STEM companies are desperate to hire women so that they don't look sexist. And the reason they will look sexist if they don't hire women is because of cunts like you.
And at the Women's Equality Party, we want to give our kids the tools to navigate their way around.
Oh, look, another black man who isn't committing crimes and is totally angelic. God, if only they could show a white man in that light. What do you mean you're going to give kids tools to navigate? What, you're going to give them free bikes? What the fuck are you talking about? You don't even explain it, man.
We plan a TFL app to make it easier for everyone to plan their journeys around accessible routes.
Oh, well, isn't that handy? This is a mayor campaign, by the way. They want to become the mayor of London, right? And we're gonna produce an app that helps you travel around London. Bitch, Google Maps. Try it. Give it a fucking try. You want to travel around London? Look up Google Maps. Put in where you want to go. Tell them whether you want to walk, drive, bus, train, whatever, fucking ever. And they'll tell you how to get there in the quickest way possible. And they'll even tell you the train, bus times. I mean, stop. Don't fucking lie to me. Don't bullshit me. You're not going to create an app that's fucking going to help everybody go around London. Jesus Christ, man. London's one of the most well-known fucking cities on the planet. You know, Google Maps have got it covered. We don't need your fucking stupid app.
We will shine a light on safety with walk-through carriages on the tube and better lighting at stations.
Fuck you mean better lighting? We're talking about London. We're not talking about some backwater fucking shithole. It doesn't have lights. London has lights. It has electricity, for fuck's sake. Some cunt's gone, God, I wanted to go to Piccadilly, but I've ended up in Trafalgar fucking Square because I couldn't see where I was going because there was none of lights. Fucking idiots.
We need improved buses in London with dedicated spaces for wheelchairs and buggies.
Right, well, there is dedicated spaces on buses for wheelchairs and buggies. This is a fact. I can't believe they don't fucking know this shit. There are dedicated spaces. What, do you want more? Seriously, you want more now? Fuck me.
More investment in a cycling infrastructure, including more integrated bike lanes. More showers in schools, colleges and workplaces to get more of us on bikes.
Yes, more showers in colleges and schools and workplaces, because then it'll be easier to accuse men of sexual harassment. Yay, it's a win for everybody, apart from white men.
And fewer heavy goods vehicles on the road, especially during rush hour, to keep us safe.
Oh yes, that's what we should do. That's a fucking great idea. So you see what I mean about the flexible working time? Why wouldn't that apply to heavy goods vehicle drivers? Oh, that's right, because most of them are men, and most of them are white. So why the fuck would they care? Why would they need flexible working hours? Why would they not need flexible working hours? But that's what we'll do. What we'll do is, right, we'll make the streets safer for bikers by not allowing heavy goods vehicles on the roads at peak hours. What a fucking great idea. I mean, don't get me wrong, all the women that work in the shops, will lose their jobs because there won't be any stock, meaning there won't be any customers because you're not getting any fucking deliveries, you mental case. But hey, at least the bikers will be safe. They'll have nowhere to fucking go because they can't go to the shop. They can't go to work because they don't have a job anymore. They can't go to the shop for groceries because there's no fucking groceries. They ran out. And they can't get a delivery until the middle of the fucking night when you're not on the road. You selfish fucking cunt. Fucking idiot, man. Oh, let's get these fucking big fucking heavy goods vehicles off the road during peak hours. And what about the fucking staff in the shops? Are they all going to get sent home early and still get full pay? I don't fucking think so. You haven't fucking thought this through, man. Fucking nutcases, man. Absolute fucking nutcases. Oh, by the way, did we tell you white men are evil? Did we tell you that? Yes, you did.
We want to participate, to turn these plans into action. So vote for us, the Women's Equality Party, because equality is better for everyone.
Sophie Walker, fucking suck my dick. I'm going to put the Women's Equality Party's Twitter handle on the title of this video, which means I will be blocked in a heartbeat. So please, if you watch this video, please share this video with the Women's Equality Party. And it's the good thing is there's not just one of them. There's like one in every city almost. Just bombard them with this shit. But fuck you, Sophie. Just seriously, fuck you. You do not deserve any position of power because you are a fucking bigot. And the people in your party are bigots. And the people that support your party are bigots. Imagine making a party political broadcast and saying, in order to get the people's vote of the city, right? And then in that fucking party political broadcast, you say, by the way, we think that half the people in the city, almost half, are evil and child abusers. Isn't that... They're just so bad at this stuff. This is the thing with feminists, right? You can't give them a job because they won't be able to do it properly because they have to push their agenda. Now, they could have done this professionally and they could have kept it, you know, about equality without making it about all women. And okay, they've got women in the title of the party, but they could have still made it about equality. But no, the first fucking thing they tell you in this... okay, not even subliminally, straight in your face, is that white men are evil and they abuse children. Children are more at risk to harm from their mothers. Men are abused and violently abused and murdered far more than fucking women are. But let's make the streets safer for women, shall we? I'm so sick of this shite, but if you go through the comments, you'll see that everybody else is as well. Please vote for me, and just, you know, half the population of the demographic that's going to, of the people that are going to vote, are pure evil, and we hate you, and we will label you not only as child abusers and bad, but we'll also teach your sons, your white sons, not to rape. Yay! What a party! Where do I sign up? Fuck you, Sophie. Fuck you. And thank you to everybody else for listening. Until next time.